Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. Today, I want to make a quick video to explain one of the biggest complaints of the brand new Insta360 Pro 2. Poor stitch. In fact, it's not really. Most of the complaints are coming from lack of experience on using the camera. First, all stitching issues can be solved easily following this tutorial with Mistika VR. Second, for those of you who do not want to use your free 3-month subscription of Mistika VR or just too busy to learn how to stitch, I also have suggestions to improve your stitch. Let's dive right in. First, let's understand the issues. If we take the raw footage from Kendall Obsidian S and R and other professional level VR360 camera, you see the single lens resolution is this. Very important is the height, which is 3000 pixels, because when it's stitched, it is flipped vertically, like so. So Obsidian horizontal coverage is actually 3000 pixels. Now, take a look at Insta360 Pro 2 when shooting in 8K monoscopic 360. It is actually 3840x1920. If you flip it to the actual view, the horizontal coverage is very, very narrow compared to Kendall Obsidian's. No matter what way you use to stitch, more coverage meaning better stitching result. So the solution is actually very simple. Do not shoot mono at all. When you shoot 8K stereo, you actually get 3840x2880 per lens. Still not as good as Kendall Obsidian, but a lot better than mono 360. If you manually stitch in Mistika VR, this coverage is usually more than enough to cover all the issues. What if you need a high frame rate production to get 60 frames per second? Well, push your subjects away from your camera more than usual and shoot with 6K 3D 60 frames per second, which give you 3200x2400, still a lot better than 1920. So there you go, that is the tip to get better stitch result by increased single lens coverage during capture stage. I hope you enjoyed this short tutorial, and in the next review, which is a big one, I will give you 10 reasons why you should or should not get the Insta360 Pro 2 based on all my hands-on experience. This camera is not for everyone, but I personally love it and work great for the contents I create, both for commercial clients and documentary filmmaking. I will again compare it with different cameras in the same price range and base my opinions on real-world footage. So don't forget to subscribe if you are considering purchasing this camera, or you already purchased this camera and want to learn more tips and tricks from me. Give me a like and support me to make more free content for you, and I will see you next time. VR Creator Level Up on Creator Up. We'll be right back.